Man, fuck going on, man. I'm living with the real on this street, man. Out of respect, I'm appreciating it here today.
What's good? So we definitely got to talk about the project that you have out now. You got 10 songs on here. Tell the people what's the name of the project and talk a little bit about it.
Yeah, man. See, okay, like, I just recently dropped a mixtape. I ain't gonna say it's an album, 10 songs, like she said, called Broken Dream, man. I dropped it, like, last month. It's going on. It's got, like, 1.2 thousand plays on it so far, trying to push for more. Well, I mean, like, the project was basically, like, I like rapping about my pain, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's more realistic. I ain't gotta try to portray something. I can talk about it. People can relate to it more. They can feel what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, yeah, exactly. And that's, yeah. You know, people feel real stuff, so that's dope. I mean, you got a song called Broken Dreams on there, right?
For sure.
Also, you got Day Ones and OTS. Yeah. Those are, like, all the songs that's popping. Talk about Day Ones, because I like that record. So did you make that for a certain group of Day One people or just in general?
Yeah, see, like, you interviewed my brother. They're like my Day One. Matter of fact, Tony.
Yeah,
my Day One. Tunes. You know what I'm saying?
That's really
the nigga that really got down, you know what I'm saying? He got me to start rap, you know what I'm saying? He the first person that had a studio when we were growing up. So that's basically where I started it. And I kind of like branched off with him when I grew up, you know what I'm saying? He's still my Day One, but I started hanging with other people that do music.
Right.
And they kind of pushed me to start taking it serious, you know what I'm saying? They were like, boy, like, you the one, you know what I'm saying? Like, what? Basically, like, Day Ones was about my Day One, you know what I'm saying? Ren's probably like, got a population of like 2,400 dead and alive, you know what I'm saying? Born and living, you know what I'm saying? So everybody know each other, you know what I'm saying? So we really close-knit. None of the people that I really rock with, like, trust people, you know what I'm saying? As far as trust, none of the people that I rock with on my Day One, you know what I'm saying? Kind of gave you a look into my current lifestyle, you know what I'm saying? I ain't been rapping for a while. Last time I did something was like Thug Cry. That was my last video I did.
Mm-hmm. Right, so right.
I had to come up out with something.
Yeah. So would you say, because I was going to ask you, like, who was the first person that co-signed you? Would you say it's Toonie or somebody else that said, yo, you hot, go ahead and do this shit?
I say got basically my fans, you know what I'm saying? Like, my brothers, all my brothers fight, so you know what I'm saying? We ain't never really pinpointed who was the best, you know what I'm saying? We just pushed each other to be better, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't nothing, no competition type shit. We weren't trying to make it for. Nobody ain't trying to make it first, you know what I'm saying? If you make it, we're going to put you on. If I make it, I'm going to put y'all on. That's the type of shit we was on. So basically, like, the city, you know what I'm saying? Like, I started, when I dropped OTL, they're really when they realized, like, yeah, that boy, they'll fight. You know what I'm saying? He hard. You know what I'm saying? I dropped the OTL. My brother, you know, had got locked up on some shit. Yeah. Nigga snitched on the type shit. So basically, I was, like, talking shit, you know?
That's crazy. Nice.
Yeah,
so
that's really when I realized that's really when they co-signed me. My whole city was fucking with it. I lost my Facebook. It had like 80,000 views on it, but I lost my Facebook for that one. So I just put it on YouTube. It's still doing good. All right, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm satisfied.
Yeah, it's still out there. People can still listen to it. So I mean, as far as you being an artist and rapping, you know, not everybody, but a lot of people rap. What makes you different from everybody else?
I mean, like, I want to say my versatility, the way I, you know what I'm saying, attack a beat. Like, that's why they call me Chop Reloaded. Like, I speed it up, but you still understand what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? I still put my pain into them bars. Like, most people say it's mumble rap, but I'm not mumble rapping. I actually got lyrics, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like,
yeah, you definitely rap
for
sure. you definitely be saying some shit.
For sure.
Definitely. So what do you want people to know about you that they might not know?
I mean, like, okay, as far as right now, people that don't know me, shit, I got a child, you know what I'm saying? I got one on the way, she'll be here in February, so I got two daughters, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
They'll hear about me when I bust through the doors of the
industry. Right, right.
That's all I'm going to say. I don't too much, you know what I'm saying?
But where do you see yourself? Like, let's just talk about next year. Like, what do you see for yourself? The level that you
next year, I see myself. Let me see. I see myself goddamn. I ain't gonna say big, but I see myself, I'm making a name for myself. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, probably like 30,000 views on Instagram. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. People tuning in. Yeah, I'm trying to goddamn, like, really, I've been doing it because of a passion.
Mm-hmm.
But I really, recently when I dropped that tape right there, I just started, you know what I'm saying, trying to really get royalties for my music and stuff. So
right.
Now I'm finna, you know what I'm saying, now I'm finna try to acquire my fan base. I've been doing different stuff, networking with different people. So we're going to see how my route going to go. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
I'm praying to God that he put me in the right direction, put me in a position to win. But,
Right. Well, I mean, you're definitely moving right as far as, you know, how you taking care of your business. And we chopped it up a little bit earlier and you said you take it serious as hell. So I know you're serious.
So
definitely. So when you like recording songs, what's your vibe like? Like, you know,
I got to have me a wood. I ain't smoking right now because I ain't understand, but I got to have me a wood. You know what I'm saying? I like to just. Sometimes I might just go to the studio, not even have no beats. I might just hit one of my producers up and be like, "Hey, bro, send me something.
Mm-hmm.
Send it to me. I do it." You know what I'm saying? But
right.
I'm just a lit ass person. I like my energy. I love my energy. I'm always. You can ask anybody here. I'm turnt. They know that.
That's good. So I know. I'm sure your shows is probably out of here.
I ain't did too many of them, but you know what I'm saying, like. Yeah, my show will be lit. I got a lot of energy. You know what I'm saying? I feel my music. I love my music.
Mm-hmm. That's cool.
I feel like I could be compared to the greatest right now. You feel me?
Right. And you still got time to grow. So that's a good thing. Definitely. So let's talk about what you got coming up. We already talked about the mixtape, but what do you have that you're working on? Videos, new songs, collaborations?
Actually, I got something set up with Authentic Empire's AG Lighty.
Mm-hmm.
He did like a little live review the other day, and I won it. You know what I'm saying? So he want me to come to Atlanta. He paying for my feature or whatever.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? Well, it's free. He ain't paying for my feature. It's free.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I just got to book studio time or whatever. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And the visuals, I'm doing the Broken Dreams, Humble, Day Ones. I'm trying to get those out the way before Christmas. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to keep it fresh. Keep being consistent. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely.
That's key.
Yep, keep coming. So what about the records that didn't make Broken Dreams? Because I know you had some that probably didn't go on the album. What you gonna do with those?
I'm gonna probably kind of like listen to them again, get a couple feedbacks, you know what I'm saying? Kind of way out. Let me step away from the air conditioning. But kind of way out which ones can be dropped or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Cause some songs not made to be dropped.
Right.
Listen to them, you know what I'm saying? Right. So
definitely.
As far as that, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? If I ain't drop them on my tape, I don't even use them no more. I might just listen to them. I got so many songs I haven't dropped because I ain't feel like dropping, you know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
So I just know when I need to drop them, and I make so much music that it come quick and I just put them together. My vibe, it's gonna make an album every time because I know my vibe. I know how I want to rap. I know what I want to rap about.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That makes it easier for me.
That's dope. So this is the moment when I tell everybody to give their key shout outs to people who definitely have been supportive. You know, I mean,
for real sure.
People that's been there from day one till now, that's just totally supportive. Name some of those people.
So first and foremost, though, I got to shout out my nigga Reloaded. You know, Chop Reloaded. Shout out my nigga Reloaded. For my nigga Narco. You know what I'm saying? Hey, shout out 800. Big Tony, you know what I'm saying? Hey, gang. Big Skiwi gang. ABK, them my bros, you know what I'm saying? Them my day ones, you know what I'm saying? Mondukes, Mila, I love y'all, you know what I'm saying? And shout out to all my fans. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for y'all.
Yes, definitely got to shout the fans and supporters out because they do look out for artists, definitely.
For sure.
So speaking of fan supporters and the mixtape, you got to give your Instagram, well, you said Facebook kicked you off, but Instagram and whatever else you have so people know how to follow you and where they can get your music.
Okay, so I'm on Apple Music, Audio Mac. You can type in Chop Reloaded. It should pop up, you know what I'm saying? On Facebook, same thing. Instagram, my Instagram is Chop 2.0 official, like the zero is for O. So it's Chop 2.0 official. You feel me? Like, so y'all can go follow me on there. I got a Twitter, but I won't be on it, so I wouldn't even get y'all that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got that far yet.
Right. That's cool. That's what's up. So Chop Reloaded, keep doing your thing. Keep making that music, that high energy music. I'm be watching out for you. Y'all need
for
to
sure.
Put that city on. I know y'all gonna do it, so it's gonna happen.
For sure, we definitely coming, man. Like, when we come through the door, We gonna flood that motherfucker too.
Because y'all got so much talent too. So I see it already happening for y'all. So that's why I've been very supportive. But keep doing your thing, and I'll talk to you.
All right. Y'all be brief.